Yeah, well, you. Yeah. I mean, you could be driving around in Lamborghinis and wearing huge.
Yeah,
I used to. Yeah, I know.
But I'm stripped all the way down now.
No Lamborghinis right now.
I don't even wear jewelry outside this Rolex, and that was a gift to me. That's why I got it on.
So why was that? Was that a personal choice you made, like recently, or is it something that? Did you wake up one day and you think, you know what?
I didn't wake up one day. What happened was I started seeing things, and I'm sitting here and seeing so many things needing to be done, so many people need to be helped, and I started feeling guilty. You know what I'm saying? Coming walking through these villages, you know, with a $40,000-$50,000 pair of earrings on and watch, you know, I'm sitting here like, all this stuff is worthless. It's useless, really, when you stop and you think about it, because it's just ornaments that you just look at. But yet it's doing nothing but just sitting on you.
What up, guys? It's your boy Quake, and I'm back with a brand new episode of What Happened To. First, before we get onto this episode, I want to say thank you for the support on the last episode on Chingy. We got some amazing views on that, and it ended up blowing up beyond my expectations. And it blew up so much that Chingy's publicist ended up DMing me on Instagram and said that Chingy saw the video and that he really liked the video. So thank you guys for watching the video. Thank you guys for sharing it, liking it, and all of that. I really appreciate it. But with a brand new episode comes a brand new artist. And this one is one of my personal favorites. He's multi-talented. He's done multiple things in the music industry. And he's definitely not a one-hit wonder. This guy has come out with hit after hit every time he dropped his album. He even signed two major artists that forever changed the music industry as well, which is really unheard of. And as you can tell by the video title, I'm talking about Akon. What happened to Akon? And if you've seen the previous videos, I start out by talking about their career in their prime, and then I talk about where they sort of fell off or basically got out of the mainstream light, and then I talk about what they're doing now. And if you've been listening to mainstream pop radio or R&B, you know that Akon at one point was controlling everything that was happening. You couldn't escape Akon at all. From the years 2004 to 2008, there was at least Akon on one track that was popping. So Akon was born in St. Louis, Missouri, but he spent most of his childhood in his West African country, Senegal. But at age 7, he decided to move with his family to Union City, New Jersey. But his family ended up going to Atlanta, Georgia, and then he ended up settling in Newark, New Jersey, going to high school there. And then he eventually ended up getting locked up for 3 years, and this is where he found his talent. Because his dad was a percussionist, his mom was a dancer, so he had some sort of art in him. So he knew that while he was locked up, he decided to write lyrics, decided to try and sing, and this is where he found his talent, which ultimately led up to the single Locked Up being released. So Akon's first official single, Locked Up, was released on April 13th, 2004, and this was surprising because the label decided to go more with a street record instead of an R&B track. Because he had a song, Lonely, on the album as well, and that was catered more to female audiences. But they were smart, because building a street audience first and then trying to cross over and go to a mainstream sound is a way better move, and you'll build more of a foundation doing that. The single did wonders for him and ended up charting at number 8 on the Billboard Hot 100, and this is when he finally got his fame, his stardom, which prompted the label to finally release his debut studio album, Trouble, on June 29th, 2004. Although the album only sold 25,000 copies within the first week. Yes, 25,000. That's so low. I mean, back in 2004, that would have been considered, they would have just dropped you from the label completely. But the label knew what they were working with, so they stuck with him. And then on December 21st, 2004, he released his second single from the album, Ghetto, which didn't do that well. It only peaked at number 92 on the Billboard Hot 100, but the label wasn't worried. They followed it up with the third single, Lonely, which was released on February 21st, 2005. And this is where Akon got his worldwide fame. With Locked Up, he sort of blew up in America. A lot of people liked him and respected him. But when Lonely came out, this was the mainstream pop hit that just went all over the world. And the reason why it's a worldwide hit is because of this. The single ended up going number one in 7 countries, including the UK and Germany. But surprisingly, in the US, it only peaked at number 4 on the Hot 100. So a lot of people were like, what the heck? That just doesn't make sense. Usually when a song is number 1 in America, it goes number 1 everywhere else. But this was kind of the opposite. It went number 1 in the UK, Germany, Australia, and other places. But it went number 4 in America. But this is where he got his worldwide fame, and ever since then it's been uphill. Regardless, how I mentioned earlier, the album only doing 25,000 copies within the first week. At this point in time, the album ultimately in America alone ended up selling 2 million copies, going double platinum. And because of that success, Akon ended up starting his own record label called Convict Music, in which he signed to Columbia/Epic Records. Now, in 2005, Akon did not release an album, but he ended up finding one of the biggest artists probably in the last 10 years, and that was T-Pain. And in 2005, he decided to help T-Pain release his debut studio album, Rapper Turned Singer. And in that, he got a bunch of success with the singles. And this was rare, because when T-Pain released I'm Sprung, In Love With a Stripper, Akon got a lot of success from that too, because that was his artist. And this is rare because Akon was on his rise to becoming one of the biggest artists, and T-Pain now at the same time is becoming one of the bigger artists as well. So it's very rare to see two artists, especially the person that signed the other artist, rise at the same time. Usually when an artist signs a newer act, the older artist ends up dying out, such as Drake and Lil Wayne. When Lil Wayne signed Drake, Lil Wayne was sort of on the downslope and Drake was catapulting up. So it's rare that both these artists were going up when they were releasing their albums and their music. None of them ended up declining, and this is why I say in 2005 to 2000, probably 8, you couldn't escape Akon and T-Pain. They were all over the place, on every hook, on every mainstream radio, on every chart. It was insane. So in 2006, Akon got back to work on his own music and decided to work on his sophomore studio album. And before he released that, he decided to release the lead single, which was Smack That, featuring Eminem. And this thing blew up. It was released on September 25th, 2006. It ended up becoming his biggest charting single at number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100 at that time. And within a matter of 2 weeks, yes, only 2 weeks, he released his second single, I Wanna Love You, featuring Snoop Dogg, on October 5th, 2006. And this song ended up topping Smack That and ended up going number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100. And ironically, this was the song that was holding Akon's own song, Smack That, from going number 1. So he was battling with himself over who's number 1 on the charts, which is kind of a funny thing and kind of a frustrating thing, because you want both your singles to be number 1, but you're battling yourself, so you're not really losing. So then Akon, with those two major successes, decided to release his second studio album on November 14th, 2006, called Convicted. The album ended up selling 284,000 copies within the first week, which was a major improvement from the previous first week sales of his debut studio album, which only sold 25,000, like I said. And then it ended up ultimately selling 5 million copies worldwide. So at this point, Akon was a huge worldwide star. He was on every single hook that you can imagine. Like I said, with T-Pain, he was on Plies' Hypnotized. He was on Bone Thugs and Harmony, I Tried, and various, various other songs.
You got me so hypnotized, the way your body rolling round and round. I try so hard, can't seem to get away from misery. If you're looking for me, I'll be on the platform, I think, possibly sitting on a track now.
He decided to also push Don't Matter as a single, and that ended up peaking at number 1 as well. So Akon was just all over the place. Fast forward to 2007, he didn't release an album, but of course, regardless of him not releasing an album, he's still looking for talent. And then he found a major, major artist that now is one of the biggest pop artists probably out right now, arguably easily. And of course, we all know that's Lady Gaga. Jimmy Iovine found her first, but he didn't know what to do with her. Akon saw her talent in music writing, saw her talent in vocal ability, saw her taste in clothing and how unique she is. So he signed him with a joint deal called Con Live Distribution with Interscope Records, where it was a joint deal where Jimmy Iovine had some of the money and Akon had some of the money.
I'm like, yo, Gaga, you got a reason. I was like, all right. But when I met her, it was crazy because I was like, wow, she's an incredible writer.
Right.
And then the next day came, and I realized that she's an incredible vocalist. And then the next day came, and I was like, she looks different every day.
Yeah, she's definitely got her own style.
No, but this is her every day.
And this is where Akon really just ended up, you know, becoming this huge mogul because he has this insane label with T-Pain, Lady Gaga. He even had Colby Aldonis, who I know was a one-hit wonder, but still, he made hits. He had Cardinal Official and many more people. So fast forward to 2008, and now Akon is gearing up to release his third studio album. And on September 23rd, 2008, he released his first single off his third studio album called Right Now, Now, Now. And then the single ended up charting at number 8 on the Billboard Hot 100. Now, that wasn't the same as having a number one hit with I Wanna Love You or Don't Matter, but it was enough to get people aware that he's releasing another album, and it was a major success all over the place. Akon then followed it up on October 4, 2008 with I'm So Paid, featuring Lil Wayne and Young Jeezy. The single ended up peaking at number 31 on the Billboard Hot 100, which wasn't that high of a success for that single, but it didn't matter to Akon at all because he already had his worldwide fame, his success, so he decided to follow up finally with the album. And on December 2, 2008, he released his third studio album called Freedom. The album debuted at number 7 and ended up selling 110,000 copies within the first week, and ultimately, total, it's ended up selling at least 1 million copies, going platinum in the United States. After that, in 2009, Akon wasn't releasing any music, but he was getting featured on songs. He was doing a bunch of collaborations with The Lonely Island, ended up working with David Guetta, Pitbull, and many, many more. In 2010, he started gearing up to release his fourth studio album, Stadium, and this is where things got shaky. When he ended up gearing up to release the album, he released the first single off of it called Angel on September 17, 2010. The song, though, didn't perform that well. Ended up peaking at number 56 on the Billboard Hot 100, which Akon is not used to. Usually gets a top 10 hit when he releases his first single. So I think because of that, it put a hold on Stadium. The crazy thing is, though, Akon wasn't succeeding with his own music, but when he was doing music with other artists, it was doing well. Like, the perfect example is David Guetta with Sexy Bitch. That was the first house type of track for Akon and ended up reaching number 1 in more than 6 countries. So he was doing well with other artists, but for some reason his music wasn't doing that well. And because of that, Stadium ended up never getting released. Actually, till 2017, still now, the album hasn't been released. He's had multiple attempts. He ended up taking a hiatus. On 2013, he released a single called Dirty Work featuring Wiz Khalifa. In February 2013, it did terrible. On November 11, 2013, he released So Blue, which was an amazing, amazing song. I liked it, but it ended up not charting at all. It ended up doing terrible. What are you doing with a girl like you? I wanna know, no, no, no. You're too fine if you're looking so blue. So blue, go, 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 go. And then on January 1st, 2015, I was expecting the album to drop this year because he released 5 singles at once off the Stadium album, and he also announced that it's going to be 5 albums that he's going to release called Stadium, but they're going to cater to certain types of genres of music. One album would cater more to the Euro-sounding music, one album would cater more to pop, one would cater more to urban, the other would cater more to island, and the other would cater more to world music. These would all have their own types of sounding tracks. I mean, urban, of course, would sound more like Locked Up and Smack That. Pop would sound more like I Wanna Love You and Don't Matter. You know, those type of sounds. And that was a great idea, but it never stuck, unfortunately. I don't know why. Until this day, we still haven't gotten that album, like I said earlier. And it's unfortunate because Akon's one of my favorite artists, but he's been doing other things that hasn't been music, which can be commended. And a lot of people are saying, hey, regardless if he's not releasing music, at least he's doing something good with his fame and his money. And what he's been doing is lighting Africa. In the midst of not being able to release his fourth studio album, Stadium, he decided to do something, and that's to help people of Africa. Where he came from, he came from Senegal, like I said earlier in the video, and there he didn't have electricity and running clean water that he can clean his clothes and drink from. And when he went back to go visit his grandma, because his grandma didn't want to move out of Senegal, she wanted to stay there. Akon was trying to get her to move out of there, live in his mansion, you know, with electricity and running water and all that in America. But she decided not to move. And Akon was like, at least let me get electricity for you, because we're living in 2013 at the time when this happened. And he was like, it's 2013. You have no electricity. I need to get you electricity. And when he tried doing it, he realized it costs way too much money for him to do it, because he couldn't just light up that house. He had to light up a whole basically neighborhood of people. And when he realized that, he decided to make some power moves and decided to talk to China and their mass producers of solar energy. And when he talked to them, they liked his idea. They decided to give him $1 billion in credit. And Akon was excited to get that $1 billion in credit. He thought it was going to do a lot. Unfortunately, it didn't. But he ended up getting more money from China to develop these rural parts of Africa.
I said, if anything, if my grandma would probably be the only one with electricity in this area. Come to find out, the grid was so far out that even if I don't care how much money I had, there was no way I could bring electricity to her. You know what I mean? So at that moment, that's when I said, okay, something got to be done about this. This has to be a solution, because now it's not just about my grandma. Everybody in certain rural parts of Africa are experiencing the same thing. You know what I mean? Like, they ain't got no electricity whatsoever. So they gave me a $1 billion credit line to start my project. And that's how it all started. At first, I was like, $1 billion? Oh, that's, I'm rich. Then I realized $1 billion ain't shit for what I'm trying to do.
He even teamed up with Shell, who's one of the biggest companies in fossil fuel and energy in America. They teamed up with him. He released a song called Tell Me We're Okay. And on this song, he's talking about his efforts to help Africa and various other countries struggling with infrastructure and having electricity. And ironically, in the beginning of this video, my sister is in this video. She starts out the video talking about the news in Africa. You can follow her on Instagram right here. It's kind of crazy that my sister ended up being in this video talking about this stuff, but that was dope as well. So that's a shameless plug, but go ahead and follow her on Instagram. And after ultimately teaming up with Shell, he ended up expanding how many people he helped. And as of now, December 2017, he's helped 75 million people get electricity, which is an insane amount of people. He's doing life-changing things now, regardless of him not releasing new music. At least he's doing something with his connections, with his money, and with his fame. But I still want an album, man. I mean, Akon is one of my favorite artists. Like I said earlier in this video, the Freedom album is one of my favorite albums of all time. I want Stadium. I mean, with singles like So Blue, I'm surprised that flopped, because it was an amazing song. Go check that out if you haven't. And I missed Akon so much that I made my own compilation mixtape that I made in 2015 of the great songs that he released back when I owned my website, DiverseHipHop.com. And on that tape, I compiled all the songs from like 2012 to 2015 that were amazing. Songs like Breakdown, go check that out. I'll leave a link in the description of that mixtape so you guys can download it and check out those songs, because Akon's still delivering great music. It's just that it's not getting promoted, or people aren't caring as much as they used to. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of What Happened To. This one was a little longer than the other ones, but that's because so much happened with Akon. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you guys think. What artists you guys want me to do next? And do you guys think Akon's gonna finally release that Stadium album that people have been waiting for years now? I mean, it's been 10 years. 10 years since 2008 was the last time we got an Akon album. So leave a comment below, like, share, and definitely subscribe. I do videos like this daily on hip-hop news, who changed the music industry, what happened to, and much, much more. So definitely subscribe. Follow me on Twitter and on Instagram. Like us on Facebook, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.